So you've done a lot of exciting research, design, engineering on spacesuits. What does the spacesuit of the future look like?
Well, if I have anything to say about it, it'll be a very tight-fitting suit. We use a mechanical counterpressure to pressurize right directly on the skin. Seems that it's technically feasible. We're still at the research and development stage. We don't have a flight system, but technically it's feasible. So we do a lot of work in the materials. You know, what materials do we need to pressurize someone? Mm-hmm. What's the patterning we need? That's what our patents are in, the patterning, kind of how we apply this. It's a third of an atmosphere.
Just to sort of take a little step back, you have this incredible biosuit where it's tight-fitting, so it allows more mobility and so on. So maybe even to take a bigger step back, like, what are the functions that a spacesuit should perform?
Sure. So start from the beginning. A spacesuit is the world's smallest spacecraft. So that's the best definition I can give you. Right now, we fly gas pressurized suits, but think of developing and designing an entire spacecraft. So then you take all those systems and you shrink them around a person, provide them with oxygen to breathe, scrub out their carbon dioxide, you know, make sure they have pressure. They need a pressure environment to live in. So really, the spacesuit is a shrunken, you know, spacecraft in its entirety, has all the same systems.
As well, probably.
Yeah,
all that kind of
communications,
stuff.
Exactly. So you really, thermal control, a little bit of radiation, not so much radiation protection, but thermal control, humidity, you know, oxygen debris. So all those life support systems, as well as the pressure production. So it's an engineering marvel, you know, the spacesuits that have flown, because they really are entire spacecraft, that is a small spacecraft that we have around mm-hmm. a person, but they're very massive. But 140 kilos, the current suit, and they're not mobility suits. So since we're going back to the moon and Mars, we need a planetary suit. We need a mobility suit. So that's where we've kind of flipped the design paradigm. I study astronauts. I study humans in motion. And if we can map that motion, I want to give you full flexibility, you know, move your arms and legs. I really want you to be like a Olympic athlete, an extreme explorer. I don't want to waste any of your energy. So we take it from the human design. So I take a look at humans, we measure them, we model them. And then I say, okay, can I put a spacesuit on them that goes from the skin out? So rather than a gas pressurized shrinking that space mm-hmm. craft around the person, say, here's how humans perform. Can I design a spacesuit literally from the skin out? And that's what we've come up with, mechanical counterpressure, some patterning. And that way it could be order of magnitude less in terms of the mass. And it should provide maximum mobility for Moon or Mars.
What's mechanical counterpressure? Like, how the heck can you even begin to create something that's tight-fitting and still doesn't protect you from the elements and so on, and the, right. the pressure thing?
That's the challenge. It's a big design challenge. We've been working on it for a while. So you can either put someone in a balloon. That's one way to do it. That's conventional. That's the
What's
only
that
thing
mean?
We've
that
ever
means
flown.
The balloon that you
that's
fill with
That's a
gas
pressurized suit. Yep. So put someone in a balloon. It's only a third of an atmosphere to keep someone alive. So that's what the current system is. So depending on what units you think in, 30 kilopascals, you know, 4.3 pounds per square inch.
So much less than the pressure that's on Earth. You can still keep
atmosphere.
A human alive with 0.3 and it's exactly. alive and happy.
Alive and happy. And, you know, you mix the gases. Do you need here? We're having this chat and we're at one sea level in Boston at, you know, one atmosphere. But a suit.
Oxygen and nitrogen.
To put a suit, if we put someone to a third of an atmosphere, so for mechanical counterpressure now, so one way is to do it with a balloon, and that's what we currently have. Or you can apply the pressure directly to the skin. I only have to give you a third of an atmosphere. Right now, you and I are very happy in one atmosphere. Mm-hmm. So you know, we can. So if I put that pressure, a third of an atmosphere on you, I just have to do it consistently, you know, across, you know, all of your body and your mm-hmm. limbs, and it'll be a gas pressurized helmet. Doesn't make sense to shrink wrap the head.
Mm-hmm.
Seen
yeah.
the Blue Man Group. That's a great it's a great act.
Yeah.
But we don't need to, you know, there's no benefits of like shrink wrapping the head. You put, you know, a gas pressurized helmet, because the helmet then, the future of suits you asked me about, the helmet just becomes your information portal.
Yes.
So it will have augmented reality. It'll have all the information you need. Should have, you know, the maps that I need. I'm on the moon. Okay, well, hey, smart helmet, then show me the map, show me the topography. Hopefully it has the lab embedded too. If it has really great cameras, maybe I can see with that regolith. That's just lunar dust and dirt. What's that made out of? We talked about the water. So the helmet then really becomes this information portal, is how I see kind of the IT architecture of the helmet is really allowing me to you know, use all of my modalities of an explorer that I'd like to. So cameras, voiceover, images. If it were really good, it would kind of be, would have lab capabilities as well.
Okay, so the pressure comes from the body, comes from the mechanical pressure, which is fascinating. Now, what aspect, when I look at BioSuit, just the suits you're working on, sort of from a fashion perspective, they look awesome. Is that a small part of it too?
Oh, absolutely. Because the teams that we work with, of course, I'm an engineer. There's engineering students. There's design students. There's architects. So it really is a very much a multidisciplinary team. So sure, colors, aesthetics, materials, all those things we pay attention to. So it's not just an engineering solution. It really is a much more holistic. It's a suit. It's a suit. You're dressed in a suit
fitting,
now.
It's
form fitting. So we really have to pay attention to all those things. And so that's the design team that we work with, and my partner Guy Trotti. We're partners in this in terms of, he comes from an architecture, industrial design background. So bringing those skills to bear as well. We team up with industry folks who are in athletic performance and designers. So it really is a team that brings all those skills together.
So what role does the spacesuit play in our long-term staying in Mars, sort of exploring doing all the work that astronauts do, but also perhaps civilians one day, almost like taking steps towards colonization of Mars? What role does a spacesuit play there?
So you always need a life support system, pressurized habitat. And I like to say, we're not going to Mars to sit around. So you need a suit. Even if you land and have the lander, you're not going there to stay inside. That's for darn sure. We're going there to search for the evidence of life. That's why we're going to Mars. So you need a lot of mobility. So for me, the suit is the best way to give the human mobility. We're always still going to need rovers. We're going to need robots. So for me, exploration is always a suite of explorers. Some of the suite of explorers are humans, but many are going to be robots, smart systems, things like that. But I look at it as kind of all those capabilities together make the best exploration team.